Kim was 9 when she spent 2 weeks with a fisherman's family in Kaikōura. The fisherman's name was Bruce, and he had a small motorboat and some woven crayfish baskets. Early every morning, Bruce would call out, "Come on, girl, up you get," and they'd head out to sea. While Bruce baited and tossed the pots overboard, Kim had to steer the boat through the choppy waves. She was proud to have such an important job, but it was a bit scary. Later in the afternoon, as the seals were yawning on the sun-warmed rocks, they'd head back out to check on the pots. This was the best part, the sunken treasure. The best pots contained 2 or 3 crayfish, their legs and feelers all tangled together. Kim's new job was to carefully stretch out the crayfish tail and measure it with an old wooden ruler. It had to be 8 inches long. If the tail was smaller, the crayfish was plopped back into the water. If it was bigger, it was tucked under the seat. Every now and then, Kim's small hands would unfurl a tail and find a nest of bright red shiny eggs. This didn't happen often, so it felt very special. She would gently lower the crayfish back into the sea, being careful not to disturb the eggs. Kim would watch Bruce's gruff old face as they headed back to shore, and she knew he loved their salty treasure hunts as much as she did.